a commencé dans l'océan.
Everything started in the ocean. This is the real
story. Si important encore
this ocean,
on a dit en volume,
which
beaucoup
is
plus qu'en surface,
more meaningful nowadays in terms of volume than area, tells us the story of life. The ocean is stable for 100 million years, it hasn't changed. This is the answer to the question we're being asked. Why is this huge ocean harboring only 13% of species? Well, connectivity, there is only one ocean, there are not several oceans, and also the stability across the time, same acidity, same temperature, same salinity, same oxygen composition. One, we're in the high seas, obviously, not close to the coast. And here we have the composition so stable that in Copenhagen, in Denmark, there is a cylinder of water which is the universal seawater. And life appears in the ocean and exits the ocean, leaves the ocean, going through the coast. And the coast is interesting. Here we have Japan, Madagascar, New Caledonia, and Catalonia, where I live.
And
here we have this separating the Roussillon plain from the continent and the sea, and we have the Canigou mountain. So in less than a few kilometers, we go from minus 2,000 to plus 3,000 meters. And here we have a few figures regarding the Japanese sea. And we have the human blood. And the human blood tells the story of how life exited the ocean 450 million years ago. Life went from the seawater to the continent through intermediate water, which is like the blood. And it's a beautiful story. Life exited the ocean several times in different places under different forms. And it then exploded in the Carbonifer forests. There are more niches on the continent being inhabited. This is the reason why we have many more species on the continent than in the sea. But the coastal water is fundamental, and human beings love the coast. 55% of human beings live by the coast, and they contaminate the sea and destroy species. These are vegetal and animal species exiting the ocean 450 million years ago. And today we have more than 80 different drugs. Centipedes were long 2.5 meters, and scorpions. They did not grow through the third extinction crisis, but the 45 million years ago, the Carbonifer forest exploded. There were huge invertebrates, dragonflies, centipedes,
and the le bassin du Congo,
tropical forest Borneo, today in Congo, Borneo, and Papua New Guinea, and Amazonia in South America are places where 70,000 species can be found on each square kilometer. Trees, for instance, 250 species of trees in Europe. On one square kilometer of the tropical forest, there's 1,700 different species, and in Colombia, 700 species of trees, and 2 million bugs are known, and 2 million species are known, and many are bugs. And Haldane said, if God exists, he loves beetles. These are species coming out of the ocean and going back into the ocean 55 million years ago when the dinosaurs disappeared on the continent and in water in the ocean environment. Niches became occupied by new species which were differentiated in their capacity to live in the environment. This is echolocation in cetaceans. Initially, they looked a bit like otters or wolves, and they ended up being whales, and they came up against oceanic sharks. So the question is, why life came out of the ocean? There is no answer. Question is, why only vertebrates and arthropods and crustaceans became insects and succeeded, as we know. This is a graph we're all familiar with, the matter of ecosystems. Life organizes itself in ecosystems, species organize themselves to create ecosystems, and obviously human activity puts a lot of pressure on ecosystems. Here we have the capacity to resist in the ecosystem against an attack. There is nature. There was nature in this place where we're standing now, and it was destroyed. But there is resilience in the system, and the system will bounce back to a certain level, not always close to the previous one, and the marine and the continental ecosystems, are they ready to bounce back and resist the pressure? If the human being was capable of doing that, making those drawings, you should be able to solve the question that matters today and should be more worried by nature. This is the Chauvet cave, 37,000 years, twice as old as the Lascaux cave. There are four species in the Lascaux cave drawings, 17 in Chauvet. How could they draw lions and rhinos, which existed in France at the time and were decimated? There are no more rhinoceroses in France. They disappeared long before the Lascaux cave. Jean-Marie Chauvet, Nîmes Brunel, and Christian Aubert in 1974. Found this cave and showed it to the world. The main stages of humankind history were when fire was tamed, Homo erectus, 600,000 years, and with fire we can prolong the day, we can harden spears, and we cook animal meat, and it's less intoxicating, and we eat much less at the time when access to resources was difficult. Then the Neolithic area, women started bearing many children, men stopped traveling and invented agriculture, and then we have the steam machine, and overnight Papin and Watt invented the steam machine, but then we need coal and oil made by initial biodiversity, and Crutzen got the Nobel Prize in 2000, and he invented Anthropocene, the term showing that the most powerful engine in evolution was the presence of man. This is the Cataluque, one of the first towns in the world, and it became Damascus. It's the oldest town on Earth, 12,000 years. And here we have some objects invented by man, wheel, bow and arrow, and gunpowder. This graph tells us the story where human demography is linked with big inventions, what I mentioned years earlier, vaccines, antibiotics, and computers. One figure, when human beings stopped traveling, there were 5 million human beings, 0.1% of the biomass of all mammals on Earth with domestic mammals. Today, 7 billion humans with all the domestic mammals, 90% of the biomass of all mammals on Earth.